What are the best settings for your WordPress website? WordPress powers over 30% of the web and allows users to build amazing websites. The problem is there are a lot of settings that need to be configured in the beginning, and I've met with so many of you who end up feeling overwhelmed and confused. The good news is, in today's video, I'm going to share with you WordPress tips and tricks for beginners. Specifically, 7 settings that every new WordPress user should know. I want to welcome you to the WordPress Made Easy show. My name is Jennifer Franklin, and I help entrepreneurs create and grow their online business websites quickly without stressing out over design or tech. If you're new here, I'd love it if you considered subscribing and ring the bell to get notified of upcoming videos. In today's video, I'm going to share with you 7 settings every new WordPress user should know. And they are your site title and tagline, your admin email, membership, new user default role, your homepage displays, search engine visibility, and lastly, permalinks. To get started, let's log into your WordPress website dashboard, and we're going to scroll down to settings, and we'll start with general. First up, the site title and tagline. The first thing you'll want to configure is your site title and tagline. Let me take you back out to the front of the website to show you what I'm talking about here. When you hover over the tab in the browser, you'll notice that when I hover over the tab, it says personal blog dash just another WordPress website. Can you see that there? So personal blog dash just another WordPress website. Now let's head back over to the general settings page, and I'm going to want to give the site title, I want to change that to my business name. So for my site title in this example, I'm just going to use business name. For tagline, you can explain what your WordPress website is about. You can use keywords, or you can just choose to leave it off. The last thing you want to do is leave it just another WordPress site. So to make your website more professional, you'll want to use your motto, your tagline, or a few keywords telling users what your WordPress website is about. So for in this example, I'm just going to choose to set my tagline as mindset and success coach. The admin email address is the email where you will receive information about your WordPress website. This was set up when you first created your WordPress website. We're still here on the general settings page, and when you scroll down to administration email address, you will have the email address you used when you first created your WordPress website. This email address is for admin purposes, and this is just where you will receive information from WordPress about your WordPress website. You'll want to make sure that this is an email address that you are able to receive email at. If you need to change this email address, you would simply enter the new email address into the box and click on Save Changes at the bottom. You will then receive an email confirmation that you need to click through in order to confirm the changes. The next setting is membership. Are you going to allow users to register on your site? If so, you will need to head over to the general settings on your WordPress website and check the box for allow users to register. And here's how. Back over on the general settings tab of your WordPress dashboard, you can scroll down to membership. For most WordPress users, you can safely leave this unchecked. However, if you're going to be adding a membership site, or sometimes to allow users to comment, you will need to check the box, anyone can register. This will allow users to register through a registration form on your WordPress website. The next setting is new user default role. The new user default role allows you to determine what level of access your new users will have on your WordPress website. Now, back over on the General Settings tab of your WordPress dashboard, right below the membership setting is the new user default role. The default role for a new user is subscriber. This allows users to edit their profiles and comment on your website. The next level is a contributor. Contributors can write and save posts, but not publish them. Whereas the next level, authors, can write posts, save posts, and publish them. The fourth level is an editor. Editors can write and publish posts as well as those created by other users. So an editor would be nice for a person to oversee all of the blog posts on your WordPress website. And finally, administrators have all access to your WordPress website. The default setting of subscriber is typically the best setting for most WordPress users. And again, it is very important to limit administrator access to your WordPress website to only those you know and trust. To recap, the general settings allows you to set your site title and tagline, your administration email address. You can allow users to register and choose the new user default role. Once you have made those changes, you're going to want to make sure to scroll down and click on Save Changes. How are you guys doing so far? I hope this video is helping to ease your confusion and frustration around WordPress settings. The next setting that is really important and where I see a lot of new WordPress users get stuck is how to set your homepage and your blog post page. How do I get my homepage to display on the homepage? And how do I set my blog post to appear on the blog post page? This is a question I get and hear from a lot of you. Or maybe you're trying to put your blog posts on your homepage. Well, you can do this all in your settings, and I will show that to you right now. Over on the left-hand side, when you scroll down to settings and reading, you will be able to set your homepage and blog post page. At the very top, it says your homepage displays. Now, there are a couple options here. The first option is your latest posts. So if we set our homepage to display our latest posts, I'll save changes and I'll let you see what that looks like. Our homepage now shows our blog posts. So it will just show your blog posts all just like a blog post page that's set to your homepage. So for most WordPress websites, you will want to have a separate homepage from your blog post page. To do this, we head back over to our dashboard and scroll down to settings and reading. In order to set a separate homepage and blog post page, you will go ahead and click on a static page. And then under homepage, you can choose from your list of pages which page you want to display on the homepage. So we can choose our page named home for our homepage. And next you'll want to choose the page that you want your blog post to appear on. Now, when I scroll through my list of pages, I don't see a blog post created yet, a blog post page created yet. So in order to designate our post page, I'm going to want to create a page for those blog posts to appear on. So I'm going to do that really quick. I'm going to click on New and Page. I'm going to go ahead and name my page Blog and click on Publish and Publish again. Now, when I view this page, you can see that there are no blog articles here yet. So I'm going to head back to the reading settings page. And we'll start again. We'll click a static page and we'll select our home page. We'll choose home. And for our post page, we're going to choose blog. Now let's go ahead and click save changes. Now for our home page, you'll see that it's now our home page displaying on the home page, not our blog page. And when we head over to our new blog page, if I refresh this, we should now see our blog post appear on our created blog page, like so. The next setting is crucial to your WordPress website being found in search, and that is the search engine visibility setting. One way to ensure that your WordPress website is found in search is to make sure that your WordPress setting is configured properly for search engine visibility. We're still here on the reading settings tab, and we've configured our homepage displays as, we've set our homepage as our homepage and our post page as our blog page. Now, as we scroll down, there is the search engine visibility checkbox. In order to allow search engines to crawl and index your site, you will want to make sure that you leave this box unchecked. So where it says discourage search engines from indexing the site, do not check that box. Now, if you are a website that is still being created and developed, then yeah, it's okay to have that box checked. But once your website goes live, you want to come back and make sure that you've unchecked that box so that your website can be discovered in search. Once you've made those changes, go ahead and click on Save Changes. The last setting that we are going to cover today is permalinks. This is another really important setting that I think we should talk about. Permalinks is another really important setting that you need to get set up in the beginning, because once your website is live and you've been creating pages and posts for a while, you're not going to be able to easily change this setting. To demonstrate this, I'm going to create a new post. And we'll give it the name new blog post and click on publish and publish. Once our new blog post is live, I can click on view post. And in this address bar, you'll see that our website address /, is a =P=2256. Now, in the past, this actually served a purpose to serve website pages faster. However, today, it's not necessarily valuable. But what is valuable is having a URL that is easy to remember and that tells search engines what our website is about. So I like to use either the title of my page or post here or a keyword. So to change our permalinks, we will go to our dashboard and scroll down to settings and permalinks. Now you'll see here that the default setting is plain, and that just means it includes like a ? P equals, and then some numbers. Now in order to change that to prettier, in order to change that to something where your title will be used as the URL, you're going to want to check post name. And this gives you an example that just the title will follow your domain name. And we'll click on Save Changes. Now here's what happens when I create that same blog post again. So I'll click on New Post. Let me call it new blog post and click on publish and publish. Let's view the post. Now you'll notice in the address bar, it's my domain name /new-blog-posts. This is what will happen when you set your permalinks to post name. It is a much nicer, cleaner, prettier URL to use. You can change each individual page or post slug by going to Edit Post, and then over on the right-hand side, you can click on permalink, and where it says URL slug, new-blog-post is the default post name. I can change that if I wanted to just say new post, for example, and then hit update. And now when I view my post, you'll see that the slug, which is the part that follows your domain name, is now changed to new-post. So just a little trick for you when you're creating posts and pages, that if you have a really long title and you want to shorten that, or you want to create a different slug to follow your domain name for that particular page, you can easily do that under the edit post or edit page. A word of caution here, you want to make sure you set your permalinks up in the beginning of building your WordPress website. If you decide to change your permalinks once you have an established WordPress website, you will end up breaking all of your links. And when someone clicks on the link to your website, they will end up getting a 404 error. And you do not want that. So it's very important that you get your permalinks set up in the beginning before you get started building your WordPress website. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you found this video useful, where I shared with you 7 settings every new WordPress user should know. If you're new here, I'd love it if you considered subscribing and ring the bell to get notified of upcoming videos. And I'll see you in the next video.
Hey guys, my name is Jennifer Franklin, and I want to welcome you to my YouTube channel. Each week, I'll bring you a brand new video, so be sure to hit that subscribe button and leave me a comment below. See you later.